Positive thinking keeps your mind open.
All right.
And your heart sensitive to the things that need to be changed.
Right.
The mindset of negative thinkers usually is things need to be changed to benefit their purpose instead of the needs of others. What I'm saying is this. If you don't realize that you want God to meet your needs, right? All of us have needs and all of us have desires. The way that you get your needs met and your desires met is by meeting somebody else's needs. That's the way change begins to happen in the world. And that's why it's a reciprocal thing.
Yes, it is.
You do something good for him?
Yeah, come on.
She do something good for him? She do something good for him?
Yeah.
And you know, it keeps going. And then it's what goes around, you know, it's eventually going to make its way. You know, what's our song we sing? You know, it's going to work in your favor. You know, what is been around and around. Mindset number 5, you got to think like God thinks, which is kingdom thinking. Luke 23:2 says this, and they begin to accuse him, saying, "We found this fellow perverting the nation and forbidding to give tribute to Caesar, saying that he himself is Christ, a king." God has one priority.
All right.
God has one agenda.
Mm-hmm. Y'all, we got y'all drew in. All right.
God wants earth to reflect heaven.
All right. Yes, sir.
Jesus told them to pray like this in Matthew chapter 6. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. In heaven. Am I misquoting it? Okay. So your responsibility is to think like God thinks. When the will of God is not being reflected in the earth, your responsibility is to bring the light.
Amen.
Alright. You said prove it. Matthew 6:33 says this. Seek first your number one priority.
Right.
His kingdom and his righteousness and all these things. What things?
Everything you need. Come on.
Read the rest of it. Read before that. You know the fishes. You don't have to worry about anything. You know, the birds don't have to worry about where their food is originally coming from. You know, the lilies of the field, they just look so beautiful. They just sway back and forth in the sun. You know, the grass looks beautiful. Everything else, they don't have a worry or care. Because they have been doing what they have been designed to do. Saints, hear me real good. If you do what you've been designed to do, you don't have to worry about your knees being met. So simple. He's created for you to do, and I guarantee you don't have to worry about it, but you gotta make sure that your priority is his priority. You gotta think like God thinks. Jesus Christ was and still is the most misunderstood world changer in the earth. People claim to know him and to understand him and even understand his message, but they don't. His whole purpose was not only to save mankind from sin, see, don't forget that, but
to change the world for us, Father. Am I messing with your mind? See, you gotta pick up your book. You gotta pick up your Bible. And you gotta read your word. And you gotta be like, wait a minute, man, what did Jesus? Just study Jesus. Study every parable.
All right.
He had one purpose: glorify my Father. Make his will be known. Make him be shown. Okay? God's plan is to rule earth through you like he rules heaven.
Yes, sir.
So pick up your Bible. This is my last scripture, John chapter 3. We're going to close. John chapter 3. Y'all getting anything?
Yes.
John chapter 3. When you get there, give us a loud amen.
Amen.
Verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher, come from God. Why? Why? For no teacher, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Okay? Jesus says unto him and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Let me ask you a question. Did Nicodemus ask him a question about being born again? No.
No, not really.
Nicodemus did not ask him about being born again. He says, you must be a man sent from God because of the miracles that you do. Jesus says unto him, well, if you're going to see the kingdom of God, you must be born again. Verse 4 says this, Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? We all know the answer to that, do we? Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say unto you, you must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof. But canst thou not tell where it comes from or whither it goeth? So is everyone that is born of the Spirit.
Right.
And Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be? I'm going to stop right there. I'm just going to basically just deal it with this. Nicodemus never asked a question about being born again.
Right.
Jesus introduces to him the notion of being born again.
Right.
Because he's telling him, you need to repent. You need to change the way you think.
All right.
Your perception of the miracles that I do. Your perception of this and of me, you can only get the right perception of being born again. You gotta receive the Spirit of God to see the kingdom. So you've got to be born again. You've got to change the way that you think. Saints, all I came to tell you today is, if you want to see your dream accomplished, you gotta change the way that you think. You cannot continue results.
Come on, Mr. Jackson.
And you say, you can't tell me how I think. You can't see into my brain. I can tell you exactly how you think about what you do. Very simple. I can tell the way that you think about yourself by how you dress. God's very smart and very wise.
Yes, sir. Amen.
God looks at the heart.
Yes.
Right. Guess what man looks at?
He
looks at your outward appearance.
Right.
So when I look at you, I can tell you the way you think.
Come on, it's on this
place. If I watch where you go, I can tell the way you think. If I watch your Facebooks and your Twitters, I can tell